Friends, in this video we are going to discuss about centrifugal pump. So before moving to centrifugal pump, let us understand what is pump. So talking about pump is a hydraulic machine which converts mechanical energy to hydraulic energy. So simple, what is pump? Pump is a hydraulic machine which converts mechanical energy to hydraulic energy. And this hydraulic energy is in the form of pressure energy. This is basically a pump. Okay, now what is centrifugal pump? Centrifugal pump, in this pump, this conversion will be by the means of centrifugal force. When this conversion of mechanical energy to hydraulic energy is done by means of centrifugal force, then the pump will be called as centrifugal pump. Okay friends, so I hope you understand what is pump and what is centrifugal pump. So right here you can see the construction of centrifugal pump. So main parts of centrifugal pump are, this is casing, impeller, suction pipe and delivery pipe. These are the main parts of centrifugal pump. Okay, here we have foot valve and strainer, and here we have the delivery valve, and this is eye of impeller. Okay, so before moving to the working, we'll discuss the principle. Principle of centrifugal pump says that the rise in pressure head that we get here, okay, the water will be filled here with the help of suction pipe, and with the help of this impeller, the water will be rotated, by which it will get velocity, and that velocity is known as tangential velocity. So that velocity, and finally we get out here the pressure head, okay. So the pressure head that we get in the output is directly proportional to the tangential velocity that we get here in casing. So principle says that rise of pressure head is directly proportional to the tangential velocity. Okay friends, I hope you understood. The moving water in here in this casing will have tangential velocity as it is moving. So the outlet pressure head is directly proportional to the tangential velocity of water in here casing. Okay, so this is the principle, short and sweet principle of centrifugal pump. Now let us move to the working of centrifugal pump. Now how it works, okay. This eye of impeller is connected to the shaft, with the help of which this eye of impeller is rotated. When this is rotated, here creates the low pressure zone. Due to this low pressure zone, the water from the sump moves upward to the casing. Okay, and the casing is filled with water. Now, here foot valve work as the upward direction valve, which only opens in upward direction valve. This is one way valve, which does not allow the water to flow back in the sump. Okay, and the strainer, this strainer will remove the unwanted particles to enter the casing. Okay, in order to protect the casing, the walls of casing and impeller. So this is the working of foot valve and strainer. So as the water is filled in the casing, it will be rotated with the help of rotating impeller. Impeller is the rotating part which is fixed in the heart of centrifugal casing. So as this rotates, the water in the casing will also be rotated like this, in this direction. Okay, and as this is rotated, the kinetic energy that the water is gaining is converted into pressure energy. So now let's see how it is converted. Okay, we have studied continuity equation. continuity equation, which says AV is equal to constant. Means area and velocity, the product of area and velocity is equal to constant at any point on the flow. Okay. So when area increases, velocity decreases, velocity increases, area decreases. So here in this casing, we see that the area here is less and gradually the area is increasing till here. Okay. So as the area increases, the velocity will decrease by continuity equation. So as velocity decreases, that velocity is tangential velocity. So as the velocity decreases, the kinetic energy decreases, because kinetic energy is half mv square. So as the velocity decreases, the kinetic energy from this point to this point, the kinetic energy decreases as the area is increasing. Now let us understand how the decrease in kinetic energy increases the pressure head. Okay. Now for that we will see Bernoulli's equation. Bernoulli's equation says that the pressure energy plus kinetic energy plus potential energy is constant. This is Bernoulli equation. Okay. So as we considered, the casing is at the same point. The points that we are considering are on the same level from the ground. So in this we can ignore potential energy. So at the end we get pressure energy plus kinetic energy is equal to constant. So if the pressure energy increases, the kinetic energy decreases, or the kinetic energy increases, the pressure energy decreases. Okay. So here what is happening, that the velocity is decreasing as area is increasing. So velocity decreasing, so kinetic energy is also decreasing. So when kinetic energy decreases, the pressure energy increases. So here at the delivery pipe, the kinetic energy is very less and the pressure energy is very high, which ultimately increases the pressure head. Okay, pressure head of the water, with the help of which we can take water from one point to another point for our respective uses. Okay. So here we have connected a delivery valve. This valve protects the water from backflow. Okay. So this is the working of delivery valve. So this is the construction. We have discussed what is pump, what is centrifugal pump, what is the principle of centrifugal pump, and what is the working of centrifugal pump. In next video, we will discuss the work done by the impeller on the water. Impeller is doing work on the water. So in next video, we will see what is the work done of the impeller on the water. Okay. So this is the very important topic. As far as we see the theory part of centrifugal pump, this is the most important part of that. And one more part also is there, that is priming of centrifugal pump. We'll see in our later videos. Okay. So I hope you understand till here. Thank you.